Hey, what's up guys? My name is Adil and today we are going to review Synology NAS DS220J. But before that, let me tell you how I have been storing my data over the past few years. I used 4 Western Digital external hard drives of 4TB and another of 3TB. I labeled these for ease of use, but still I have to remember which files I put on which drive, and I cannot access my data if I am away from my office and I don't have these drives with me. Recently, I started working on a new YouTube channel, and each 4K video project folder size is around 200 GB. So either I can buy another external hard drive, or I can get a network attached storage device like Synology NAS DS220J. So the question is, why do you want a NAS? For me, the simple answer is that I can centralize my data in one place and I can access it on any device. There are a lot more features to talk about, but first, let's do a quick unboxing. It comes in this eco-friendly box with a carry handle up top. And inside the box, the first thing you have is the NAS unit in a fabric sleeve, a 60-watt power brick, black Cat 5e Ethernet cable, screws for the hard drive, and mounting bracket for 2.5 inch drives. Okay, so here is the 220J. It has a plastic body, so without hard drives, it feels very lightweight. On the back side, you have a fan, 1GB Ethernet port, 2 USB 3.0 ports, a DC power plug, and a Kingston lock to secure your NAS unit. I prefer the USB ports to be on the front side, as these are sometimes difficult to reach. On the sides, you have the Synology logo that has ventilation. On the bottom, you have more ventilation and rubber feet. On the front, you have status light, LAN light, disk usage lights, and power button. To get inside, you need a left and right unit to slide. One side is just plastic cover, and the other side holds all the components and hard drive tray. The CPU is Realtek RTD1296, that's a 4-core CPU at 1.4 GHz, and it has 512 MB DDR4 RAM. These specs are ideal for a home server and a small office. It's good enough as a file server, storing and accessing photos, videos, and documents, and that makes it one of the best budget NAS options. When it comes to hard drives, you want to look at drives that are specific for NAS use. And two names that are recommended by most are WD Red NAS drives and Seagate Iron Wolf drives. For high performance, make sure you get 7200 RPM drive. There are also enterprise versions for higher speeds and longer warranty, but it costs a lot more. So I choose these two Seagate Iron Wolf 12TB drives. To install the drive, simply slide it into the mounting bracket and push it gently so it connects with the SATA connector. After installing the drives, make sure to tighten the screws to secure the drives. Add back the side cover and tie the two screws. Plug in the Ethernet port to your router and add the power plug. Push the power button and in a minute or two, it will be ready to connect. On browser, type find.synology.com and it will automatically find the NAS server. Click connect, read the user agreement. Click on Setup, then click on Install Now, and the Disk Station Manager will be installed in a few minutes. On the next page, you need to set Administrator Account and set a Quick Connect ID. Next, you can allow the device to be shown in network locations like in Windows. Once you sign into the DSM, it will show you a few tips. The first thing I want to check is storage volume. And by default, it's Synology Hybrid RAID, in which it has one drive failure protection. But for just 2-bay NAS, it decreases the total storage volume that I can use. I already have all the important data in my external drives, and considering the NAS drives are designed to be long-term use, I will take the risk and use RAID 0, in which I will have the maximum storage but no drive failure protection. Before we talk about its operating system, let me share my experience with Synology NAS DS220J. When connected via 1GB Ethernet cable, I am getting around 110 MB transfer speed, and on Wi-Fi 5, it's around 60 MB. On Wi-Fi 6, it will be around 80 MB. Accessing the files on Windows is easy. You map the drive once and access all files stored on it. Directly playing 8K files up to 1.5x speed is absolutely fine. I have been using it as my Plex Media server, and being able to play 4K files in original quality on this budget NAS is absolutely a great deal. But if you want to transcode media, don't get this NAS. The CPU will not be able to handle even transcoding of 1080p media. The best thing about having a NAS is it will work like your own personal cloud storage, and you can access your files anywhere in the world when connecting to the internet. You can synchronize and backup your files from all devices using Synology Drive app. The only thing that would have made it perfect is a better CPU, because right now if an app is installing or updating, I am unable to open any other app. If it's indexing files, the performance is terrible. Even you will not be able to transfer files at half speed. Another thing that I don't like is it has only 1GB Ethernet port. If it has at least 2GB Ethernet ports with Synology link aggregation, you can get transfer speed of around 200 MB. When it comes to the noise, the fans are never loud in my test, but the hard drives do make laudable noise when transferring the data. So I will suggest don't keep it at your desk. I will move it to another room just because of the writing head sound of the hard drive. So to wrap this up, if you are considering getting a 2-bay Synology NAS, you have 4 options. If you want best performance and have money to spend, get the DS720 Plus. The DS220 Plus is more of a mid-range NAS, and DS220J is the best budget option for beginners to get into the network attached storage world. If you are considering getting high-end models like 4-bay NAS, DS918 Plus or DS1019 Plus, I will recommend you to wait for a few months, because there are rumors that Synology will introduce newer models with 2.5GB Ethernet. And that's the only reason I got the DS220J instead of spending a lot on high-end models. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any question, post in the comments and I will do my best to answer. If you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to support my channel. Hit the bell button so you can get notified when I post new videos. Wear a mask and stay safe, my friends.